All right, sweet, what I say, there you guys say. All right, so this is going to be your next 6 months in relationships. Let's look at what's playing out for you in your relationships, what kind of relationships you need to focus on, kind of archetypes you need to embody to be in the best relationship, what you need to work on in your personal relationships, and these relationships cut across your romantic and your non-romantic relationships. So think about your relationship with your friends, your family members, your work colleagues, your business associates, your business partners, your clients, and all of those. Okay, so this is going to be a full-out look at what relationships are calling for your attention over this next 6 months, and then what you can do to get yourself ready, what you can do to get yourself in place, and what you can do to better focus on these relationships. Okay, and now you can also show for yourself in this relationship. So we're going to start off with the overall energy for water signs. So Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, you guys might be saying 111, and I'm really feeling like this is for you. The next 6 months is really going to focus on your business relationships, like how you exchange your resources for income, your skills, your gifts, and all that. What I kept hearing was this intro to, I'm not sure if it's by Neo, but it's just this intro, the business, it's a song. But all I kept getting was just the intro, the business, okay? And then the other one is, tell me what you want from me, take a look and you will see. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. So those were just the two songs I kept on playing repeatedly while I prepared for your reading. Alright, so let's go into the reading, baby. Alright, what's it wrong? Let's take from my show what that sounds. What's happening in your relationship for the next 6 months? Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. I'm really at my first sip of tea. So, I forgot to still up. You're missing something. Just be yourself. First and out of the box. Just be yourself. You're a great person. Enjoy being yourself. So all I'm seeing is like, you guys are in on your journey. You're currently on your journey. Your path is winding. There have been many curves. But it's essential for you to realize that only you can be on your path. Only you can do your thing. Only you can show up as you are. So over the next 6 months, you're really going to be stepping into that realm of embodying more of yourself, okay? Love from your parents, no matter what your mother and father, love you as much as they can. Yeah, there's also parental love coming in here. It's almost like that's this opportunity to be yourself as you go along this journey. Can you see the winding path through the mountains, through the valleys, just staying focused? No other support, but the bird, what the bird is showing me there is like, okay, and now I'm seeing they're like two doves. So it's like, even if your parents are passed away or their life is you, it's something about this over this next 6 months, you also get like a lot of confirmation. Even however your initial growing up period was when you're a child, however the relationship was at that time, over this next 6 months, it's like you guys are also going to like work on healing your relationship, work on building a closer bond to one another, and that's going to really, really help you in building more self-confidence and more self-love. Next, you've got confidence. The best way to be good at skill is to practice until you get it right. So as I was saying about your path being very curvaceous, some of you would have felt like, okay, you should have gotten to your destination now. You should have achieved your goal. You should have gotten to the pinnacle. You should have made all the money you want to make. You should have gotten everything done now. But it's like there's still more for you, and part of the journey is like part of the, it's really not about the goal, it's not about the end point, it's about the journey itself. That's one thing you guys are coming to realize, and you're going to, and what I'm also hearing is by the time you get to that pinnacle you think you've been wanting so much, you'll miss these days of new beginnings, of learning, of building your skill, of refining your skill, of owning your skill, of getting, of just being more, of doing more, of seeing yourself more, of, you know, becoming more of yourself, of putting yourself in new situations and being like, oh, I could actually do that, when you look back, those are the moments you remember and you cherish the most. Not exactly when it feels like everything's already happening, when all the money has come in, when you have all the employees, when your company is so big. What you remember is the starting days. You guys, what I'm getting is also a strong feeling of entrepreneurial activities. So this is less you being an employee. Even if you're an employee and entrepreneur, meaning you're like an employer, you're like an entrepreneur in your workplace, meaning you take hold, you're responsible for results, the actions, the decisions, everything. So it's like you're the entrepreneur there. But this is just very entrepreneurial skills, what you can do by yourself, building something from base, from scratch. Next, you've got truth. Yes, what you're talking about is the truth. Young black baby, brothers and sisters. So your family is very important. To get along with others, see the love and the best within them. Excuse me. Family culture, learn about your family stories and history. Listen to your true feelings. Don't let others stop you into doing something that you know is wrong. Alright, so what I said, over the next 6 months, your family is going to play a very important role for you. For some of you, you're doing something different from what your culture or your tradition expects or what has always been done. But I'm also hearing like what you're doing is not so different. Only if you trace your path back to like go. Flip the page, go to your family tree and look at what your great-great-great-grandparents did. Not your immediate grandparents or your great-grandparents. It's like your great-great-great-grandparents, and you see a likeness between what they did and what you're doing now, or the business you're trying to build now, what you're trying to create now. Okay? For some of you, you might also have like adopted siblings, or there are people you've come to adopt as you grow through life, and you might be closer to these people than your real siblings. Those are also your family members. But for the next 6 months, it's very essential for you to just be yourself, for you to be true to yourself, for you to continue to practice your skills so that you can continue to grow, for you to focus on learning and absorbing the, what I'm hearing is absorbing the practices, the rights, the wealth that dwells in your ancestral line. Try to tend towards doing things that more culturally acclimatizing, if that's the word, or like things that drop from your roots, relying heavily on using the things already exist in your past, in your tradition, in your culture, and then maybe modernizing them or creating them for a new environment or for a new audience, but leveraging what has already been in existence in your tradition and your culture is going to be very significant for you as you're moving forward. It's like you're merging the old and the new, you're merging traditional and you're merging the modern to make a new thing. That's where I'm also getting the feel of entrepreneur. So you guys, what you're working on is like you're bringing the past into the present and you're making it you're modernizing it, or you're innovating it, or you're improving on it for the future population, for the future audience. So as I said, be yourself and listen to your true feelings. Your true feelings, if you are not, even though it feels like personal relationships are second place for you. So first and foremost is what you're doing for yourself, your business, your entrepreneurial activities. That's first thing on your mind. Secondly, your family, okay, building a stronger bond with your family. And then the last thing is your feelings with maybe an intimate relationship. But this is what you're being asked to do in this return, in this spot, in this space, is the fact that you just need to continue to listen to your true feelings. Your true feelings will not hide, they will not mislead you, okay? Don't let others stop you into doing something that you know is wrong. You know what is wrong. You know what is right for you. Alright, baby. Let's go into the reading. I'm going to start off with Scorpio because all the while as I was preparing you. Okay, so as I said to me, little song, God just came up. Oh, kept on coming. Scorpio. I'm like, okay, I'm going to start off with Scorpio. Alright, my love. I love you. See you on the other side. If you like to be carried on me, the link is on my bio. Be better than that. That's good. Okay.